Beijing Zhuhua Amusement Rides Manufacturing, or Zhuhua Rides, has long been my favorite Chinese coaster manufacturer for their laughable coaster names and designs. But this company deserves some respect as they have tried to innovate and create their own coasters without just knocking off pre-existing ones. Beijing Zhuhua Amusement Rides Manufacturing was founded in 2003 in Jiaotongshan, Beijing. Zhuhua Rides then built their first roller coaster in 2006. It was a fairly basic family coaster named Rainbow Children Coaster at Sun Park in Beijing. That same year, they also came out with a basic spinning Wild Mouse coaster with a design clearly inspired by what French company Reverchon was making at the time. However, Zhuhua Rides' model was notably different in that its drops were shallower and its supports were completely different than what any Western coaster manufacturer was using at the time. They would go on to build 8 more spinning coasters until 2010, when they built their next coaster model. In 2010, Zhuhua Rides joined the club with Golden Horse and other large-scale Chinese coaster manufacturers by debuting their own knockoff version of a Vekoma SLC, Dragon Rider at Floraland in Chengdu. This coaster was a direct knockoff of Chinese manufacturer Beijing Shoblai Amusement Equipment's own knockoff Vekoma SLC. Zhuhua Rides is different in that they did not make an exact copy of any existing Vekoma SLCs, but instead made a knockoff of a knockoff. That same year, they also built one of their spinning coasters in Argentina. Zhuhua Rides is different than a lot of other Chinese coaster manufacturers in that they have a desire to export their rides to countries outside of mainland China. In 2011, they built a second and third children's coaster. Like their first one, these both had a unique layout and trains. 2013, however, was a huge year for Zhuhua Rides as they debuted 4 new coaster types, starting with their most clear knockoff yet. Motorbike roller coaster at Panda Paradise. This roller coaster is an exact clone of Vekoma's motorbike coaster 600 meter, installed at Chimelong Paradise in 2006, a park known for allowing Chinese manufacturers to examine the Western coasters they install. In 2013, they also debuted what seems to be an indoor family spinning coaster known as a Star Coaster. This model seems to be unique to Zhuhua Rides. They also introduced their now comically famous Crazy Skateboard. This ride is a spinning coaster with high bank turns and a Wild Mouse inspired layout. From what I can tell, it is also unique to Zhuhua Rides. Crazy Skateboards can also be bought with seats facing inside or out. Zhuhua Rides' last new for 2013 coaster model was the Mine Coaster, a mine train style coaster with track clearly taken from Vekoma's motorbike coaster. However, it used a unique layout and trains. In 2014, Zhuhua Rides came out with a new ride model known as the Home Coaster. This coaster has a unique layout, but its trains are very clearly copied from Mack Ride's Youngstar Coaster. The only Youngstar Coaster in China is, of course, at Chimelong Paradise. Other than the Home Coaster, they continued to install their new ride models from 2013 through 2018. In 2018, they released their newest coaster model to date, the Super Skateboard. This is a scaled-up version of their Crazy Skateboard model from 2013. It's a mostly unique design and shows that Zhuhua Rides likes to innovate, and while they do make knockoff coasters, they only do it to survive in a super competitive Chinese market. Overall, Zhuhua Rides is far from the worst Chinese coaster manufacturer, especially when compared to some of their competitors like Golden Horse. However, parks like Chimelong Paradise are at the source of the Chinese knockoff coaster boom. These parks allow Chinese manufacturers to closely examine Western coasters at their parks, allowing Chinese companies to make direct clones. All of these knockoff coasters are a symptom of a much larger problem of intellectual property theft in China, a problem that will remain unsolved under the leadership of the Chinese Communist Party. Only when the Chinese Communist Party is removed from power will it be safe for Western companies to build their rides in China again.